There exists a unique form of energy in our universe. It's a natural element comprised of three atom particles, proton, neutron, and electron. Through the magnetic light and electric field, it's called prana. The flesh we see is not everything about a human body. Together with our 12 chakras, the body interacts with nature through various light and electromagnetic field and frequencies. Meanwhile, high and low frequency energy waves are generated. If the frequencies reach harmony, the inner layer of the spectrum and radiation turns white, touched with gold. The outer layers forms a complete energy sphere. While the sphere is in the most stable condition, its surface gets to resonate with the universe and absorb the energy through our nervous system. The inner layer of the sphere combines the five elements of nature: metal, wood, water, fire, and earth, with nutrient and hormone inside the body as fuels to create energy. Through the 12 chakra system, the fuels are fed into the energy reactor inside the body for transformation, which is very similar to the process of nuclear fusion. The life force created by the nuclear reaction through these three layers is what we call prana. The condition of newly formed prana is almost like plasma, a kind of luminous liquid energy that we already have in our nervous system. Basically, our neural filaments can be divided into four layers. The middle layer is prana that flows as liquid plasma. The second layer is fluid. The third layer is light. The fourth layer, which is the outermost one, flows in the form of electricity. Our nervous system extends to all parts of the body. The 12 main meridians and neurofilaments that are even smaller than capillaries densely cover the whole body as a system. Statistics shows that a person's overall length of neurofilament could actually wrap around the earth. Clearly, they are pretty important to us. Prana has fundamental effects on the human body. Infancy, childhood, and adolescence are the key period of human growth. During the development, in order to get the essential nutrients we need, high energy prana links with our nervous system to make sure we have strong digestion and absorbability. At the same time, more prana emerges. Humans in this stage of growth tend to eat more. The bones and muscles grow faster. We are always full of energy. Our wounds heal fast, all thanks to prana. On the opposite, as we age, prana decreases rapidly due to work pressure, an irregular lifestyle, and bad habits, and we are visibly affected. For example, we start to have a decreased appetite. Fat builds up more easily. We get wrinkles and all that, which have something to do with prana, for sure. Prana is luminous liquid energy. When the energy is high, there will be high heat inside the body. It's just like lava that produces heat, while it is also the core of our kinetic energy. As simple as that. The second layer fluid is the early form of prana, before transformation. The third and the fourth layer, light and electricity, interact with each other to release both energies, forming the magnetic field which boosts the circulation system to stimulate and revive cells and burn the fat. Nowadays, more and more people work out to stay healthy, to keep in shape. It's good. But when you no longer fall into the young category, you might notice that it took you less time to stay fit when you were younger. You didn't need special nutrients to build muscles. It takes you more effort and time to do so as you grow older. That's because you don't have as much prana as before. You need to exercise more to produce heat energy, to produce the luminous and electric fields. In this episode, we have explored how prana affects our body. There are more about human body and the universe to be told in the future episode. I'm Dr. PH. This is Science, Not Religion. Time is ticking. Please share our videos to your family members and friends and ask them to help spread the ideas. You can help more people. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.